A very good morning, everyone. Good afternoon and good evening, wherever you are. Thank you for the ICONET ISI 2020 committee for inviting me as a speaker in this conference. My name is Charles Lim. I'll be sharing my research entitled HoneyNet Threat Sharing Platform. You probably already heard the introduction about me. I'll be just adding a little bit on my research interest. First, my research interest is in the area of malware, intrusion detection, vulnerability analysis, threat intelligence, digital forensic, and cloud security. I'm also involved in several community, Indonesia HoneyNet Project, Packet CSIRT, and AFD. The research is actually granted by ESIF Asia, a foundation of APNIC back in the September 2019. The research is actually a collaboration between Swiss German University, Badan Cyber Sandi Negara, and Indonesia HoneyNet Project. The goal of this project is actually to develop and implement a HoneyNet threat sharing platform that will actually collect, store, and add contextual information for cybersecurity threats. The agenda today is I would like to introduce some honeypot concepts and we'll share the HoneyNet project threat map. And we also talk about the threat sharing platform architecture and how they are actually used to detect honeypot threats. And finally, we will talk a little bit about the campaign timeline and research output. First, let's talk about honeypots. What is actually honeypots? Honeypot is actually a decoy system that actually designed to lure attacker to interact with it. It actually emulates popular service such as web, SMB, SSH service, and many other. It actually plays together with other network services, and basically, honeypot doesn't contain any useful information. As you can see in this slide, basically honeypot can be placed in actually outside the firewall, the DMZ, and also inside your network. Basically, you can use the honeypot to actually capture any traffic that may be actually found in the network. The way HoneyNet actually or honeypot works is actually we place actually honeypot in the special design ports where most of the ports are actually used for administration. For example, the SSH port 22 actually used for managing the server remotely. So we actually put them down into other ports such as 22,222, so that the server administrator will go to this port for administrating the port, while the port 22 actually used for SSH. So in this way, if there is any attacker actually attack on port 22, they will be redirected to a special port where we can actually capture the honeypot interaction, such as port 2,222. Here is the example that we have actually captured all this time from the honeypot data, and we actually mapped them into a threat map. And this threat map is actually a long time collaboration since 2012, and this threat map actually already hosted in Badan Cyber Sandi Negara. And as you can see in this threat map, on the very left, we can see that the top five countries that is actually attacking our country. Second, we can also see the live feed, the actual live attack to specific port that actually attack to our honeypots. And on the middle, we can actually see the actual map of the countries actually attacking us. And on the right-hand side, a list of the malware that actually used to attack our countries. On the very bottom of this middle portion, we can see the statistics, number of attack actually found in our honeypots in Indonesia. Currently, we have about 54 honeypots distributed in 18 province. So here is the architecture of the threat sharing platform that we actually designed. On the very left, you can see that there is a honeypot actually distributed in different location, and they are actually collected into through the HP feeds, and they are actually pulled to a HoneyNet parser engine, where the parser engine actually parse all the data before they are put into a data lake. And the data lake actually contain all the data before they are actually analyzed by a security analyst. We can also add some information from the malware that we capture using sandbox analysis like Kuku, and add those information into the data lake. Once analyzed by the security analyst, we can actually display them in a dashboard that we already provide. And those information are ready to be shared with other community. Next, we will actually talk about what is actually being detected in our honeypot. So since we are implementing the two most common honeypot, such as Pauri and Bionia, for example, Pauri actually detected SSH service. Bionia, on the other hand, actually detect a few services such as FTP, HTTP, Microsoft SQL, and many others. In general, this honeypot will usually detect them in several channels. For example, in Kauri, we can actually see the peer IP, which is actually attacking IP address, and also the login information, such as the user ID and password, and also the command that they send to actually interact with the honeypots. Now, on the other hand, Bionia actually have three channels. Similarly, they have an attacking IP address, and the connection actually contain the URL. They actually interact with the honeypots, and also honeypot also contain the payload that they actually send to our honeypot when they try to infect our honeypot. Here is some of the threat category that we detected in the Pauri honeypots. For example, as we can see, there are profiling system, and these are commonly used by the attacker while they try to profile our system. For example, what kind of hardware we have, maybe operating system, and many others. At the same time, they also do user enumeration. Also, sometimes they also create some backdoor port so that they can communicate with the command center. These are some of the threat category that we have detected, and there are many other that we cannot list them one by one. Here is some of the threat example in the HoneyNet Pauri honeypots. For example, in the attacking IP address, we found, for example, 35.202.41.48. One of the shell command they actually send is, for example, they usually prepare some directory before they actually download some, for example, shell command. And then later they change the shell command to be executable. And this shell command actually was actually detected using a hash, so we can actually later identify them using the hash. Also, you can find some multiple instances such as root and passwords that they actually send to our honeypots. The third category example that we also see in this, we actually map them into military attack. For example, the CD command, we actually map them into a usable directory discovery, and then they are mapped into military attack file and directory discovery. Another command such as wget is actually a download tools, and they are mapped into T1105 and then also T843 for remote file copy and program download. So these are some of the mapping that we actually did for mapping the Kauri honeypot threads. And the next one, we can see them as a thread correlation. As you can see, we can actually map the IP address that is actually attacking us and also thread that actually used to attack us and including other possible threads that is actually in the chain found in the same server. And finally, we can also see the dashboard that has been used to display and to collect all the threat actually found in the honeypots. In this public dashboard, we can see there are 6 honeypots. These are experimental honeypots that we actually use to collect all the data. And within a week, we can see about 6 million plus attack. And we can see on the left-hand side, the origin of the attack, which is actually including Indonesia, part of the origin of the attack. And on the right-hand side, we can see type of malware actually attacking our honeypots, including Trojan downloader, ransom, and even unknown malware. And in the third category, monitoring, we can see that there is a lot of port scanning and also doing brute forcing. And some of the commands actually include payload delivery, execution of tools, privilege modification, and many others. In the third pattern monitoring, we can also find some sometimes unsuccessful login and also some unknown yet threat pattern that we are yet to discover their threat. So sometimes we can actually see the attacker also do many activities in the timeline, meaning that they usually do something to our honeypots and then they stop, and then maybe after a while they do attack again, and then we actually discover them this threat campaign, as we can show you in the next slide. For example, in this threat campaign, we can see the threat pattern code of SCS-005. They're actually doing system profiling and try to be persistent in our system. As you can see, they are actually very heavy pattern in this categories. They are found in May, they are also found in June, and also they repeated in July. And it seems that they stop altogether in July. And the other threat pattern we can see that is SCS-006. They actually try to disable firewall, and they also do tool execution and persistent. And they are only found actually in May, and after that, they no longer attack us anymore. And so another campaign would be pattern code SCS-010, which is actually a tool execution and try to cover their tracks. They actually exist in May and then try to repeat in June and July. After that, they stop. And then there are other threat actors actually repeat from May, June, and July. So again, this similar attack can actually appears for some time and then they disappear, but sometimes they actually repeat for some time before they stop. So all of this research from our observation and our threat category, we have documented them and actually published them in a paper, which you can actually participate in the conference paper presented by my student. And this again is a result of the research collaborated by SGU, Badan Cyber Sandi Negara, and Indonesia Hanenet Project. And the paper actually entitled XTPOT, Exposing Threat Category of Honeypot-Based Attack, which will be presented today in our conference. So, with this, we would like to thank you for your time, and we hope this presentation will actually help you to understand our research which is actually a research of the collaboration between Indonesia HANENET Project, SGU, and Badan Cyber Sandi Negara. Thank you.